by United Nations 191 countries decided in September 2000 to make certain goals. And maternal health has been kept very near to the heart in those goals, that is goal number 5. And it has been decided that the maternal mortality has to be reduced by 75% of what it was in 1990 by 2050. So with this, we have been given a goal to achieve the maternal mortality ratio of 109 per 100,000 women per year. Now, whenever we keep a goal, to achieve that goal, we have to have continuous advancements and knowledge. And to have those advancements and knowledge and changes, we have to have an interaction and update our knowledge about that goal. So this workshop is a step towards getting that goal, and I hope the knowledge we people gain from here will make us a bit of difference in making the goal to achieve easier. So, the latest data say that every day approximately 800 women die from preventable causes related to pregnancy and childbirth, and 99% of all maternal deaths, they occur in developing countries. Maternal mortality is higher in women living in rural areas, and young adolescents, they are more prone to maternal death during pregnancy and delivery as compared to older women. So skilled care before, during and after childbirth can save the lives of women and newborn babies. Between 1990 and 2010, there is almost a 50% decline in maternal mortality. Globally, total number of maternal deaths have decreased from 543,000 in 1990 to 287,000 in 2010. There is a decline of maternal mortality to 210 as compared to 400 globally from 1990. And developing countries account for 99% of maternal deaths, and most of them are in sub-Saharan Africa and Southern Asia. And in Southern Asia, 19% of total maternal mortalities are occurring in India. And almost all of them are preventable. 19%. So what is proportion of maternal deaths by state? Total maternal deaths in India are 56,700. 73% of maternal mortality are focused in five large states. That is Uttar Pradesh, 36%, Bihar, 13%, Rajasthan, 10%, Madhya Pradesh, 9%, and Assam, 5%. UP, where the maximum rate of maternal mortality is there. Maternal mortality ratio is maximum. Now, if we see the latest SRS bulletin, which was in 2011 and it gives statistics of 2009, the maternal mortality ratio of India has reached a figure of 212. Have we counted that every life that counts? Are we estimating a fair sample by a sample registration survey, or we are underestimating it? The truth is that still, though we are saying it is 212, but it is more than 212 as it is underreported. Almost 600 fully filled jumbo jets crashing every year. It is the maternal mortality of India is like that. I told you that Millennium Development Goal 5, it targets towards maternal health. If we see the pyramid, South India has been able to achieve the Millennium Development Goals. And UP and Assam and other states are far behind it. Why do mother die? There are so many conditions: hemorrhage, sepsis, hypertensive disorders, abortion, and other medical conditions are accounting for 34%. This shows a big building, a slum area, a rural woman, and a urban woman. And the ones who are dying are the people with the least influence and power, the poor and the rural peasants, and above all, they are women. Muhammad Fatehullah said, women are not dying because of disease we cannot treat. They are dying because societies have yet to make the decision that their lives are worth saving. The three delays, delay one, delay two, delay three, about which we'll be knowing in detail. The timely human service is most important. We know that in PPH and APH, the time with us is only 2 hours and 12 hours. And if we give blood transfusion when the condition is irreversible, then what is the use? There is no use. And they gave me 5 units blood, but it was too late to save. So it has to be, care has to be given well in time. It can. There are three key requirements for safe motherhood. Every pregnancy, a wanted pregnancy. Skilled care should be available. And transport to appropriate services should be available. ENOC, emergency obstetric care, has to be given to everybody, every pregnant lady. Why still we are not able to decrease the maternal mortality? Because still, till date, we are working at high-risk approach, target-oriented approach, and great emphasis only on antenatal care. We have to give equal emphasis of intranatal and postnatal care, because maximum maternal mortalities are occurring in postnatal cases. So we have to give care to all the three places. What is slowing us down? It is number of functional PHC and FRUs which are still less, blood is still scarce, and infrastructure and capacity building is still lacking. Again, the roads in the urban area, they are very good, but in rural area, neither the health facilities up to date nor the way to reach them. What is really slowing us down is India spends only 1.8% of GDP on healthcare. Not on the it is not now, slowly and slowly it is coming on the political agenda, but till date it has not been taken seriously. We have to introspect ourselves. Medical education system. We are giving a right education in a right-oriented way. Paramedicals, are they have been skilled in everything which is required to take care of a mother? Private health delivery system, are they monitored? Public health system, are they efficient and focused? Development models, do they care for environment and common people? So to conclude, investing in mother health is worthwhile investment every care provider. MDG goal, I have already told you, 109 per 100,000 live births. We have to respond to call for establishment of effective maternal care. We need to have improved data collection system, focused, guided maternal health delivery system for all. One preventable death is one too much. Get involved in reducing MMR in our country. Donate time, treasure, and death. So this is the request that we all have to do. We have the skill, now it is time to show our will. You may be disappointed if you fail, but you are doomed if you don't. So.